Hello, this is Sonja from My Happy Space. Welcome back at my channel. Today we're going to do some scriptural journaling again. And we're having sort of a mini-series in the scripture journal looking at the prayers of the Bible. Now, I've done two prayers in the Old Testament and I'm doing my second prayer in the... Or two prayers in the New Testament and I think I'm doing my second prayer in the Old Testament. I've got this beautiful pattern papers. It's from Amity Bloom. I've used some things from her before. I will link it down here below. And what I'm wanting to do is I want to do a barn door. They call it like a barn door. It's a fold out. And then sort of in the center of this barn door, you can write your journaling or whatever you prefer. And this is where I'm going to write my journaling. This is also part of her printables. And it's very beautiful. It's vintage. I'm actually mad about her printables. It's absolutely gorgeous. It's right up my alley. It's vintage. It's pink. It's blues and all those things. So first of all, I'm going to cut the paper to size because obviously I've printed it and sometimes... you can't get it totally on the A4 size. And then I'm going to fold it over. At first, I thought I just need one or two pages. I don't know how I worked it out. But then I realized now the one side when I'm going to fold it over, I still need another one. So I just quickly printed off one. So I'm going to just use my white glue just to put it together because it's a nice strong glue that dries very quickly. So I'm just putting it together. So I've got this long rectangular sheet and then I've cut that middle part also off. Now I'm putting it in the middle of that long rectangular sheet. So as I said, I can do my journaling in there. And then you're going to see me fold the barn doors in a minute over. And I've struggled quite a lot. I didn't actually follow the instructions. I followed a YouTube tutorial earlier, so I didn't look very well at it, so I had to stop and I had to think about it. So basically I'm folding it over now at the edge of that inside bit where I'm going to do my journaling. And then I realize when I fold it over, oh, this is going to be white, it's not going to be blue. And then that's when I printed out my other piece so I can put it on top of that whiteness. So I'm just trying to work now out. I'm trying to fold it to the middle. So basically you fold it over and then you bring it to the middle and then you make it flat and then you do exactly the same to the other side. I've fiddled a little bit with it backwards and forwards and until it's more or less in the middle. There's probably, if you do it sort of right from the start, it probably would have been easier to do it like that. So I'm just cutting the excess off because it was obviously a bit too long. And then I'm just putting it on my book to see exactly how it works. And then I realized for one other reason, I didn't fold it exactly to where that blue is. And then I realized, oh, my barn doors is not properly closing. So I'm just fiddling a little bit backwards and forwards. And then I realized, okay, I just need to fold it in a different spot. Luckily, because I'm going to put some patterned papers on top of it. It doesn't really matter if there's loads of creases on top. But I'm sure if you now did a double-sided paper, it might have not looked very nice having all these creases on top. But at the end of the day, it's just experimenting, trying something new. And I love this idea of the barn door opening and you can pulling it open and your journaling is inside. So while you see me fiddling around, let's talk about what prayer I'm going to look at. I'm going to look at a prayer of David. You can find it in 2 Samuel 7. And you can actually also find exactly the same prayer in the story in 1 Chronicles 17. So God obviously wanted us to know the story. It starts off with David being in a very good place. There's peace in his kingdom. And he had a desire to build a temple for the Lord. And Nathan the prophet said to him, that's fine, you do as your heart desire, David, because he obviously knew David was a man after God's heart. But that night Nathan got a dream from God to say, no, I don't want David to build my temple for me, but what I rather want to do is I want to build David a house of David, where his seed will be established forever and his kingdom will be established forever. And Nathan told this to David, and then David gave this prayer of gratitude towards the Lord. And 2 things stood out for me. The fact that David had such a desire to build the temple, But when God told him, no, I don't want you to build the temple, it's not meant for you. Later we found out it's because he had blood in his hands. He was a man of war. And it is going to be his son, Solomon, who's going to build the temple. He wasn't angry or bitter about it. And he, even if he was never going to see the fact that his house will be established forever, it's never going to be really realized in his lifetime. He's not going to be necessarily the beneficiary of it. He still went to God and he gave God praise him that God wants to build him a house. So God flipped it over and said, you want to build me a house. You want to do something good to me. But I, as going to turn it around, I'm going to build something better for you. I'm going to establish your house forever. So I'm just going to read you a little bit of a few of the verses from verse 18 of the prayer. It says, who am I, O Lord God, and what is my house that you have brought me thus far? And yet this was a small thing in your eyes. Because of your promise and according to your own heart, you have brought about all this greatness to make your servant know it. Therefore you are great, O Lord God, for there is none like you, and there is no God beside you, according to all that we have heard with our ears. And now, O Lord God, confirm forever the word that you have spoken concerning your servant and concerning his house, and do as you've spoken, and your name will be magnified forever, saying, the Lord of hosts is God over Israel, and the house of our servant David will be established before you. For you, O Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, have made this revelation to your servant. And that is beautiful that God said, I'm going to build you a house, the house of David. And yeah, it's just God's character. As I said, if we want to do something for God and he close a door for us, then he will give us something better in return. Better for him to give him more glory, or better for us. And we just need to trust him and be in gratitude towards him for whatever he wants to do in our lives. My final touch to this barn door is just putting these little flowers on there, and to use almost, it looks like door handles when you open it. And now I'm just putting it in my journal, and I'm going to put it together or clip it with a paper clip in there just to keep it in there. One thing I'd like to remind you of, I've put a video up yesterday asking you to vote to let me know what devotion you'd like to see this month for me doing. So there's two options. So if you can go to my previous video, I'll link it up also here at the top. Just to have a vote, choose A or B. It's a very short video, just 2 minutes, just to see what devotion we're going to do this month, or I'm going to dig into this month and feature on my YouTube channel. So I'd really appreciate it if you can go and check that out. So I hope you enjoyed this entry. And I hope you're encouraged by God's goodness and his grace. And if you like this video, please give it a like. I'd really appreciate it. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, I'd love to have you on board and become part of this family. And you must have a fantastic day. I'm leaving you with close-up photos. Thank you very, very much for watching. And see you soon. Lots of love. Bye-bye.